Discover the power of test flight with this comprehensive video tutorial. In this step-by-step guide, I walk you through the entire process of setting up and harnessing the full potential of test flight for your app development projects. Whether you're a seasoned developer or just starting out, you'll find this tutorial invaluable in simplifying the testing and deployment of your iOS apps. Get ready to streamline your app testing process and take your development skills to the next level with TestFlight. Be sure to check out developer.com/swiftui-camp. You will see the details later on in this video. Now, we are going to talk about TestFlight and how to set it up and how you can make your users test your app with delight. So, we are going to set up, enable, upload our application, and then make sure that your users can test that application. It will be a kind of a longer video, but make sure to check out the sections down below if you want to skip any of the steps where you have already implemented it. So what we need to do first is have an app. So let's create a new project right over here. I'm going to just build up this from scratch so you will not miss any steps. So we are going to have an iOS testing test flight. It's a good appropriate name. Let's click on next right over here. Let's drop it, maybe on our desktop. I don't read the Git repository for this tutorial. Let's create a dev project. There we go. We have our demo application. Now, what do you actually need in order to be able to submit to TestFlight? Well, first of all, you need an application on App Store Connect. Therefore, you want to have this bundle ID that we have created right over here. And I'm going to go under signing in capabilities to be able to copy it out. There we go. Under the bundle identifier, this is our bundle identifier. This needs to be available on App Store Connect. Now, the easiest way of making that is to just simple enable a capability right over here in-app purchases. That's my favorite one. It's just going to upload the provisioning profile. And after that has been done, we can just simply remove in-app purchases. But, you know, I just want to double check that Xcode has created that bundle identifier. So what we want to do is go to developer.apple.com and log into our account. Select account right over there, log in when it's requested. And what we want to do is create an actual app. You know, we go to App Store Connect under apps. Okay, there we go. And click on this plus button right over here and select new app. Now, first thing, I want to check if the bundle ID has been created right over here. So let me just check right over here. And here it is. So now I can just select it and select iOS for platform or whatever you are going to have name. I'm going to copy and paste that to the SKU and English, US for primary language. I would choose full access because, you know, it's my application. I want to have full access. Oh, there are one or more validation errors. The app name you entered is already being used. Now, this is really frequent. So why you just add in here developer? App name has to be unique. And also, therefore, the SKU number. Let's create that. And most probably this name will not be used. I would be surprised if this app name was used. Okay, so yeah, now we have our App Store Connect app created. And if we just go right over here under Test Flight, you will see that you have to upload your builds using one or so of the several tools. Yeah, we are going to use Xcode. Now, there are internal testers and there are external testers. We are going to cover them in just a second. So let's go right over here back. And we could just archive and upload this. But there is one issue. We need to add our app icon. It's a must. So let's create an app icon. Well, if you don't have anything like Photoshop or anything like that. I just like to use Photopea for this. Let's create a new project and 1024 by 1024. Let's create that. And what I'm going to do is just add a color right over here, and that will be my icon. So let's export as PNG, and I would just go icon. Let's save that. And now I can go back to Xcode and just simply drag and drop this right over there, and we have our app icon. Of course, yours will be much more sophisticated, hopefully. Now, let's take a look at what we are going to upload. Go under General and you will see your version. I usually want to have major, minor, bug fix, so 1.0.0. And here we have build number one. We are going to upload build number one. Okay, so you want to select any iOS device, and then right over here under Product, you just want to select Archive. And that will archive our project. It will just basically zip it into an IPA file. Now, after the archive has succeeded, of course, this was really, really fast for me. Yours might take a little bit longer because you actually have features inside your app. You want to distribute and select Test Flight and App Store if you want to include both. But now I'm just going to select Test Flight internal only. We are going to test internally through our Test Flight app. Okay, click on next right over here. It's preparing, analyzing version. Yeah, doing its regular stuff, communicating with App Store Connect. Of course, you want to make sure that you are logged in into your App Store Connect account with Xcode. Let me just show you where to do that. You just go Xcode settings, and then under accounts, you want to make sure that you are logged in. Otherwise, you just click on this plus button and just add in your credentials. Okay, so it's uploading, which is really, really nice. And it says it's uploaded. Really, really great. I click on done. I usually want to delete all of my created builds. So I just hit return right over here and delete this. It's just taking up space on my computer. Okay. Are you ready to embark on a transformative journey in iOS app development? With SwiftUI Camp, you can become a SwiftUI master in just 4 weeks. SwiftUI Camp is designed to equip you with the knowledge and skills needed to excel in SwiftUI development. From building captivating user interfaces to crafting efficient and elegant code, I've got you covered all the way. Join today and unlock the full potential of SwiftUI, taking your app development career to new heights. Visit redeveloper.com/SwiftUI-camp now to secure your spot and start your SwiftUI adventure. So now let's go back to our App Store Connect and let's refresh this page. Okay, let's just see that it's loading. There we go. We have version 1.0.0. Of course, the build is not available right over here just yet, but after a few seconds or minutes, this will be available. And it says, to start testing and collecting feedback about your app, create a group and invite testers using their email. Okay, so let's create a group. Group name, enable automatic distribution, that's fine. We are going to create an internal group. You know, we have this internal testing, meaning that whoever you have under users and access, and I'm going to jump right over here, users and access, and you can see that here we have all of our users. Now you can select any of these in your internal users. So let's just go back right over here, and we are under internals again, and we can just add in our testers. You know, just select any of those. I just select one of this. Let's just add. So yeah, we just have that. And as you can see now, currently under builds, we don't have builds available. Now, what we want to do is just go back to Test Flight. Just click on right over here and make sure that first of all, it's not processing. It would just say it's processing if it is processing. This was a small app, so it processed it really, really fast. You can see this is build number one on version one. Here is our icon, and it says missing compliance. So yeah, let's manage that. Let's click on manage. Export compliance information. Do you have any encryption, basically? So if you don't have any encryption, which I don't at this in this app, I'm just going to select this one and click on save over there, and then it's ready to test. Now, in just a minute, just make sure that you take a look at the captions. I will make sure that we don't even have to do this extra step. We are going to do this in Xcode. So, but let's just go under internals, and now you will see that build number one from version number one is available and it is testing. Now, I most probably have got a notification from the Test Flight app. If you don't have the Test Flight app on your phone, then make sure you download it. And also, you can resend the invite if that is the case. You will get an email, and yeah, you can just tap on the email, and that will open up Test Flight or the App Store to download Test Flight. And that is internal testing. Okay. I will promise you that encryption thing, I want to make sure that inside our Xcode, we are going to set it up, because, you know, you need to set this up for every new build that you upload, or even version, of course. So just go select your targets info and click on the plus right over here. And if you just scroll over here, you will see app uses non-exempt encryption. Just select that and just set no right over here, which means we are not using any encryption. Now, we changed something, so we want to upload. We want to upload a new build. Therefore, we go under general and we just bump the build number up. Now, if this version one was already on the App Store, then we would just change also the version number, maybe 1.0.1, and set the build back to one in our case. But, you know, you just want to bump up the build when you are working on a one particular version, or if you are bumping up the version, then of course make sure that you also bump up the version number. Okay, so that's that. Now we want to also archive. So let's select any iOS device under product, select archive. Let's just wait for this to be archived. You can see it was really fast for me. Distribute app. And now I will just say Test Flight and App Store. So this one you will be able to also submit to the App Store. Okay, let's distribute right over here. Fetching app records. Yeah, it's just going to do its thing. And let's just wait for this to process, uploading, analyzing package. Yeah, just you can just fast forward if you want this. So we have uploaded version 1.0.0, build number 2. Click on done. Usually let's just delete this and close it. Now let's go back to Test Flight. Okay, so if we just click on Test Flight right over here, now you will see, well, actually, we just need to refresh here because the new build, it's just going to be processed. Let's just wait for this a few more minutes. Here we go. It's processing. You know, I just caught it while it is processing. So you just need to wait for this to process. It usually takes about 5 minutes or even less. Let me just refresh this again. Well, okay, App Store Connect, really like your error handlers. So, ready to submit. Okay, so it's ready to submit build number 2. Now, you see, we did not have that export compliance, kind of warning right over here. We are already in the internal testing group, so that's fine. We can just add, yeah, we are already in the internals. So, let's create an external testing. Let's click on plus right over here and externals. Now, externals are those who don't have email addresses under your users. So you can just send out a simple link and users will be able to download your app onto their test flight apps. So let's just click on builds. Let's just see if we have any builds. Yes, ready to submit. Let's just select that. Next, let's add in all of the test information. If needed, then also add a username and password for the sign-in. We don't need that at the moment, so let's click on next right over here. What to test? Test my first version of this app. Okay, submit for review. Now, so it looks like App Store Connect is not really good with numbers. My phone number wasn't accepted. So let's go under here, under test information. And yeah, let's just complete here our test information. Okay, now let's click on save right over here. Yes, the phone number, we are having an issue with the phone number with App Store Connect. So it seems that Safari is not good enough for my phone number. It, for any reason, it did not accept my phone number when I tried to add the build. So let's click on build and now in Chrome, select this build right over here and click on next. And now let's add our information. Sign-in is not required in my app. Let's click on next right over here and automatically notify testers. That's fine. Test my app for bugs, please. That's our submission. Submit for review. Here we go. We have our build number 2 with version 1 enabled. Now, what you can do is just add some testers, you know, new testers, and just first name, email, and last name. That's fine. We can also set a public link. Now, how to do that? Now, it still says waiting for review. What that means is the guys from App Store Connect will take a look at your application briefly, and it will just approve it for external testing. Once they do, you can just have a public link available and you just send it off just like that. Now, this application was a Swift UI application. It was really, really a small application. If you'd like to learn more and you know, learn Swift UI, go ahead and check out swiftuicampdeveloper.com/swiftui-camp. And also, if you'd like to add a cool splash screen into your application, make sure to check out this video right over here.